Hi, in this video we're going to be implementing Stack in C++, and it's going to be a template class like the previous ones that we've implemented. We've implemented so far dynamic array and linked list. And you know, Stack is really not on the same level as dynamic array or linked list. In fact, we can implement Stack using dynamic array or linked list. So in C++, std stack is just a container adapter for the underlying containers. And by default, the container that is used is std dq, double-ended q. And but also you can use as an underlying container for std stack, you can use std vector and std list. So in C++ standard library, stack is just a container adapter. But I'm gonna implement stack as a dynamic array just because it makes sense, since we always push on the stack, we push on the top and we pop, so get an element from the top. So we always push and pop at the same position, the very end. So we don't get any perks using linked list. You can check out the advantages and disadvantages of linked list and dynamic array in episode 1 of this series. Now, I could simply use the class that we wrote in episode 1, dynamic array, but I've decided not to do that, so that stack class is gonna be a standalone container. I am, however, gonna copy code from our dynamic array class because it's very similar to our stack. Basically, stack data structure just adds a bunch of constraints. Those constraints are, we can only insert elements at the top. So that would be pushing on the stack, and we can only remove elements from the top as well. That would be popping from the stack, I guess. And the principle of stack is LIFO, last in, first out. Last in, first out. So we stack elements on top of each other so that we can, we cannot remove something that is in the middle of the stack. We can only move from the top of the stack. I mean, literally, if you imagine a stack and you stack, I don't know, some cubes, you can only remove from the top and you can only put on the top, because if you try to remove from the middle of the stack, it's gonna fall, right? So let's get into the implementation. I'm gonna create stack.h, and from dynamic array.h I'm gonna copy everything. We are gonna strip it down a bit. For example, we don't need exceptions because we're not gonna have indices, because we only have the top of the stack to work with as a user. We call it stack. This remains unchanged. Now pushback is gonna remain, although we're gonna just call it push because we always are pushing to the top, and our top is gonna be the back of an array, but to the user it won't matter. Our implementation, it's just if in our implementation, you know, behind the scenes, we're actually pushing to the end, so, and popping from the end, but we call it top. This will remain the same, and I'm gonna explain the code once I remove all the unnecessary parts. So first, type elements, it's just a pointer to the beginning of an array. I encourage you to watch an episode on dynamic array just so that you understand what we're doing here better. max index is just index of the last element in the array, and it's gonna increase as we add elements and decrease as we remove elements. And capacity is kind of how much memory have we do we have allocated for elements. Once we reach the size of a stack that exceeds capacity, we have to reallocate memory, a bigger block of memory. And in fact, in push, this here we check if max index plus one is equals to or greater than capacity, then we reallocate the memory to a bigger block. Also in destructor, it's important to free the memory that we allocate during the program. Reallocate function is gonna be private. The user is not gonna know about it at all. Here we allocate a bigger memory block, which is gonna be capacity multiplied by 2 plus 1 to minimize the amount of allocations, since allocations take time, and also copying the elements from the old memory block to the next memory block. We're gonna update the capacity value to what we have allocated, and then we delete the old memory block and set elements to point to the new memory block. Okay, so this is pushing to the top, so we check if we whether or not we need to reallocate. Then in any case, we increment the max index value because we're pushing, and then we put the value to the top of our stack, meaning to the end of our array. Okay, so now we need to implement a function that just returns the value that is currently on the top of the stack. So it's gonna return the a value of the type type and simply top, and we're gonna return elements max index. But if our stack is empty, then max index is gonna be minus one, and obviously we should not access the location minus one because we don't know what's in there in memory. So if it's the case, if max index, let's say, is less than zero, then we are just gonna display a message: stack is empty. And we're gonna return type. And now we have to implement the pop function, and basically we're gonna check if our stack is empty. We're simply gonna display the message "stack is empty." Otherwise, otherwise we're gonna just make max index, we are just gonna decrement max index. So now, so we just shift the top, and yeah, that's as simple as that. Also, we have this function here that's left from the dynamic array, a size, it just returns the current size of stack. And yes, as you can see, stack is really simple. So 45, top is 45, 3, 4, 5, 6. If we pop now, the top should be back to 5, back to 4, back to 3, back to 45, and now it should be empty. Yeah, top is 0, which is the default value we return if top stack is empty. And yeah, thank you. Bye.